A lot of agency owners lose money every single month because they have no idea how long their client work is actually taking them. It doesn't matter to me if you offer subscription services or you do things hourly, maybe you like to do flat rate projects. If you're not tracking your time accurately, chances are you are either over delivering to your customers or you are undercharging, probably both, but they are both affecting your profitability. As an agency owner or a service provider, you need to know exactly how much time you are spending on each client, because that data tells you if you are profitable, if you need to adjust your prices, or if you're just spending 15 hours on something that you quoted five for, which I am definitely guilty of. Now, I get the problem. I'm a service provider myself. I'd love to have that information, but the issue is that time tracking itself takes time, and nobody wants to constantly be starting and stopping timers or filling out spreadsheets at the end of the day when you can barely remember what you did that day anyway. That's where a tool like Toggl Track comes in, the sponsor of today's video. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how you can use it as a service provider, as an agency owner, to track your time without it being another burden on your workload. Time tracking has to be effortless and transparent, and thankfully, Toggl has been around the longest out of any time tracking tool I know about. I'm sure they're not the first, but they are definitely the most well integrated across all of the tools that I use on a daily basis, which is almost reason enough to use the tool, but it's actually very, very good. Let me show you. So here's my Toggl Track account, and it might look like a lot at first glance, but trust me, after a few minutes, you're gonna understand this application perfectly. And the truth is, you're probably not gonna be inside of the application all that much because the integrations are so deep that no matter what you're doing, you can probably just begin tracking your time wherever you are. There's no reason to come back to the website. I really just come back here to do admin stuff, to check my reports, to set up new client accounts, which you could do with their API if you're clever. You could just integrate it with your onboarding and everything would work seamlessly, something I want to do in the future for sure. So I'm gonna show you around the app here in a moment, but first I wanna show you how easy it is to just begin tracking your time no matter where you are. A great place to start is the applications that are available. These are the Toggl Track apps themselves. They're available for Android, iOS, as well as desktop, Mac, and Windows. So go ahead and get those installed and basically you'll have access to your timer wherever you're at. Just a click or a tap away. There's also a browser extension, so no matter what website you're on, you can have your little time tracker button right up here, ready to begin tracking your time. The browser extension has a ton of integrations right into your favorite applications. So here is Notion. If I wanted to begin tracking my time in Notion, they actually add a button right into the UI. So just click it and you can start tracking immediately. In fact, you can even have it auto track your time. So you don't even have to click anything. It just works automatically. And this works on a ton of different websites. The browser extension has a ton of different integrations. So it really doesn't matter what tool you're using. You can have it auto track if you'd like, or just add a button right into the UI of the tool you're already used to seeing. And one thing that I love is I manage WordPress websites. So you can even add in custom URLs for specific integrations, like clientamp.com is our website. It's a WordPress website. So anytime I'm working on that, it can just automatically start tracking. But what if you want to turn on time tracking manually? Well, I'm going to show you here. I'm on a website. Let's say I was updating this website. I want to start tracking my time. I can click right up here on the browser extension, and then I'll just enter a description in. What are you working on? Now, as soon as I click on this, it's going to show me a list of my recent projects. So if I'm doing the same things over and over again, chances are I don't have to type anything at all. But let's say it's a new task. I'm going to do website updates, right? I'm going to assign this to a specific project, website management, and I can even tie it to a specific client if I like. That's important because then we can bill them later. And there's a great integration for invoices I'll show you in a moment. You can tag your work here. I think this is so important. I'll explain in more detail later, but it's really nice to know how much time you're spending on web development or reporting or research or what other tasks you might be doing. It's great to know that across all of your clients. The last option you might want to consider clicking over here is whether it's billable time. So when it's lit up, it's billable. Right now it's not. Let's begin tracking. All right, so now I'm tracking my time. I could go about and do my work. And when I'm all done, I'll come right back up here and just hit the stop button and I'll see it added to my list of efforts down below. All right, next we're gonna talk about setup. This is the most important part to your success. You wanna have a nice system in place so that it actually feels useful and you get some reward out of using it. Otherwise, it is going to feel like another burden. So here is how I recommend setting things up as as a service provider, as an agency owner. You're going to start off by adding in your clients. So I've got 4 clients added in here for demonstration purposes. For each client, we are going to add projects for that client. It could be reoccurring tasks if you offer website management services, or maybe you're working on a new redesign of their logo. You can add that in as a separate project itself. So let me show you what it looks like to add a client. I'll just click right up here where it says new client, and then I'll enter in my client name. It's Legacy Brand Co. And let's add in the project that we're going to be working on together. Now, when I click here, I can start typing in the name of the project, or it's going to show me any projects that don't have clients currently assigned to them. So I don't want to choose website management. I'm actually going to create a project for packaging design. So you can see here as I've typed that in, I have got the project available to select for this client. So I'll just click create client. All right, now they show up in my list of clients right here. And as I click on the disclosure triangle, I can see the projects assigned to them. And I can do this for all of my clients. So let's say I click on Elevation Fitness here. I can go into the actual project. We can see how many hours we have already worked on their project, what the billable amount is, how much time we have left in our proposed budget. So we've got about 5.5 hours left. And that just helps me know whether or not we're on track to meet their expectations, or if we're gonna end up over serving them. So there's actually a few more steps to creating a project that I like to do after I've added in the initial projects for the client. So let me open the one up that I just created, and then we'll choose edit project. The next thing I'm gonna do here is click on advanced options, and I'm gonna go ahead and set up everything that I want to know for the duration of this project. So if it's a recurring service, I would toggle this on. This obviously is not, it's a one-time service. I am going to add in a time estimate because we kind of have a budget set up with the client. We know how much they want to spend. We know our hourly rate. So even though it's a flat rate project, I'm going to add in a time estimate so that I can actually hit my profitability marks. So for this project, we are estimating 20 hours and we have a custom billable rate for this particular client. We're charging them more than our typical hourly rate. You can see here it's 150, but for this project in particular, because we have some extra costs associated with it, we are charging them $200 an hour. The last option down here is for fixed fee. And you might think that's only for people who are charging flat rate for their projects. The way I see it is this is actually like the budget for the entire project. And you'll see what I mean here in a moment. But I'm gonna go ahead and all you're really doing here is some basic math. 20 hours, $200 an hour, that's gonna be $4,000, right? That's the entire budget for the project. So I'm gonna save all of this. And now it's gonna ask me, you know, you're changing your rate. So I'm gonna do that. Now, if I look at my projects right over here, I'm gonna get some metrics. So here is the one that we just created, packaging design for Legacy Brand. Now this starts tomorrow, so it's not active yet. That's what that little timer sign means. But now I can see I have used 0 of my 20 hours and the number that I set for the fixed budget or the fixed price is $4,000 and we have not used any of that yet either. So that's great. We can see that we have some room to work here. Some of my other projects are either complete, like this brand guidelines one. We stayed within our budget here, $3,000, 20 hours. Now I'm done with this project, so I can go ahead and archive it. I can just select it right here, choose archive, and it will be out of my dashboard. For some of our other projects, we're actually getting close to the budget of the client, and we don't want to go over budget. We also don't want to give them more hours than they have paid for, even if they think they got a flat rate. So like this logo and brand identity here, there's only about $500 left in the budget. So what I can do is click on the triple dots down here, the kebab menu, and I can set up an alert. So I'm gonna say as soon as it reaches 80%, I wanna go ahead and get an email. All right, so I've set up an alert for my email address. I'll choose create alert, and there you go. As soon as this goes over the limit, that 80%, it's gonna say, hey, you guys need to slow down or talk to the client, figure out a plan to go forward so that everything gets done and everybody's happy. Here is what that alert looks like. I've reached 80% of the fixed fee, so it lets me know, hey, it's time to take some action. Now there's a funny little symbol on the screen here. I wanna point it out. It's this little arrow that's kind of looping back on itself. That's the symbol for a recurring project. So any project that is marked as recurring, this one is a monthly project, it's gonna show up with that symbol. Let's go ahead and edit our website management project and make that a recurring project. We can kind of go through all of the settings one more time. I'll choose edit project. And again, inside of the advanced options, we'll turn on recurring. This is going to be a monthly recurring project. It's gonna have a time estimate. I do 3 hours per month. month. We'll use our workspace rate of $150. And of course, that means the cost to our client is going to be $450 per month. All right, I'm going to hit save here. Now I've got the symbol here that indicates it's a recurring project, but even cooler, I can click on the triple dots once again, choose that this is now a template, and I might want to pin this so that it stays up to the top. I can reload and you'll see that it now lives at the top of the screen. Now, anytime I get a new client, I can come in here, click the triple dots, new project from template, give it a name. Let's say it's, you know, Steve's website management. There we go. And now I can assign this to a particular team member. Maybe someone else is taking care of Steve's website management. We're going to give this to Amy here, and I can choose whether or not they are a regular member or a project manager. And I've got my advanced options down here, but I don't really need to worry about this too much because they're all filled in for me from the template. The only thing I might want to do is choose the client. In this case, it's Steve. We'll add in a new client named Steve. There we go. And now it's all set up. Simply create the project and you can see it populates right here. So that's basically everything you need to know about projects, but I'd be remiss if I didn't mention the fact that you can start the timer right here inside of the application. So let's say I wanted to work on Steve's website right now. I can go ahead and start the timer directly inside of the app. You can see us doing the little countdown up here. I can click the pencil and add in all the details if I like, but the timer is currently running. So don't worry, you can do the work, and before you stop the timer, you have to add that in. So it's required. I've set up my workspace, by the way, to require a description because I want to know, I don't want to just a bunch of empty receipts like you track time, but what did you actually do? That's my preference. Something you can configure here under settings, and you go ahead and just choose set required fields for time entries. I like to assign it to a project that's required, and I also require a description, but the task and the tag, that's up to you if you want to add that in. Earlier, I mentioned that you can add additional users, and that's really easy to set up. Just head over to the members section right here, choose invite members, and you'll be able to add in their email address and assign access. So there's a lot of different permission levels. You can really give someone just the right amount of power, but not too much. So we've got admins, team leads, project leads, and workspace users. There's options for most of these roles, so you can really dial it in exactly as you need. You don't want someone who's supposed to be working hourly to be able to modify their times, or, you know, just depends on the trust levels with your different workers. I also mentioned a moment ago that I've got a workspace rate set up. So my workspace rate is $150 per hour, but that doesn't mean we don't charge other clients different rates. So I've set up the default. Anytime I create a task, it's going to cost $150. All tasks by default are billable. I can toggle that off, obviously, but if I wanted to charge a particular client a different rate, you already saw that inside of projects. So social media management, I'm gonna go ahead and open up the triple dots here. I can get that done a lot cheaper. So we are charging them just $100 an hour. And before someone leaves a comment, I'll just go ahead and say, yes, this is all fake data, fake rates. I'm just doing this for demonstration purposes. Next, let's check the report section. I really like this. It's very usable and you get a lot of actionable information here. The filtering is great. So if you want to look at a specific member, an employee, to see where they're spending their time, you can go ahead and choose the employee and it's going to show you all of their data explicitly, nothing else. You could also do the same thing, but with a client or a particular project and just get a log of everything that's happening for that project. Like, for example, here is a logo and brand identity project. We've spent 4 hours and 45 minutes on it this month. But if I go to last month, which should be right here, now I can see that we actually spent 19 hours on it last month. We have not billed for this yet. So with a single click, I can go ahead and click create invoice. It created a full invoice for me. All I have to do is give it an invoice ID, enter in my address, their address, maybe add some custom information here like payment details. If I want them to do a bank transfer, I could add that in there and then I'm good to go. I can simply just click save. I got to add that ID in, hit save, and I can go ahead and send this right over to QuickBooks where they can pay online or just download it and email it directly to them. Yeah, there's a button to connect to QuickBooks so that it just takes that invoice and creates it over inside of QuickBooks. Pretty nice. I think setting up your tags ahead of time is super critical. I mentioned that at the beginning of the video when I was starting the timer for the first time. So these are the tags that I have for our services. I just list them all in advance before I even use them. That way, when I'm going ahead and creating the actual event, so we're still tracking our time up here. If I click on this, start editing it, I can see the list of different services, and they actually have very good key commands here. So if I wanted to, I don't know, say client meeting, I can start typing client meeting. I can use my arrow keys and just hit enter and it selects it for me. Then I don't even have to get, I'm still using my keyboard, which I love. I don't have to grab my mouse. I could type something in like strategy. I typed it wrong, but there we go. I can select that one. Now I've got both of them selected. It adds those tags to my event. I'm going to add in my description here and hit save. Now when I'm all done, I will stop my time tracking and it's going to show up in my list of things that I've done today. Now this was obviously not a real event, so I can delete it. I can click the triple dots and just delete it. But this is also fully editable. So if you make a mistake and you want to change something, we'll just go in there and start typing. You can call it whatever you want. My very important task. Oops, I assigned it to the wrong client. You can change all of that after the fact, assuming you have the right permissions, of course. If you're out for a client lunch and you want to attach a receipt, you can even do that. This little icon that shows up here lets you upload a file like a receipt to attach it to that task to track your expenses. Super cool. I'm in the list view here, by the way, but there's also a calendar view as well as a timesheet. So whichever view you prefer, it's available. Now for me, I like using tags when tracking my time because then I'm not just seeing how I'm spending my time on one client, but I can see maybe where I'm spending a lot of time across all of my clients. Maybe I need to hire in that department, or it's something I should cut out entirely because it's just taking up too much time for how much profit it's generating. So to see that data, what you want to do is go to reports and then choose workload and group by tags. This will show you all of your tags over here and then how much time you actually spent on that tag. So design is by far the thing that's taking the most of our time. So if it ever gets to be too much, we'll be able to look and see, well, who is doing the design? Who is taking the most time with it? Is someone not being effective with their time? There's just so much information that you can get from utilizing tags. So if you want to get started with Toggl, go ahead and click on the link in the description. They do have a completely free plan, so you can try this out. It might be enough for you. It's free for life for up to 5 users. If you want some of the features that I utilize, like projects, you're going to need to move up to the starter plan, but still it's only $9 per user. My thanks again to Toggl for sponsoring today's video. If you've got any questions, hit me up in the comments. I try to get back to everybody. Hit like if you enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you're new around here. My name's Dave. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.